其實我哋又唔好要太過去介意我哋做出嚟嘅作品俾唔俾西方接受，因為建築始終係應該係服侍我哋本地嘅社會為主。
Since Hong Kong Palace Museum threw open its doors to the public in July this year, architect Rocco Yim's name has been in the spotlight.
咁翻嚟嗰個感覺咧，其實都幾開心。通常博物館氣氛係好肅穆噶嘛，咁但係次次嚟到有小朋友走嚟走去啦，樓梯上上落落啦。有老人家靜靜地坐喺度睇風景啦，亦都有遊人即係上上落落周圍去，好似探索去發掘咁。咁而呢個正正係我想製造嘅嘢嚟，即係個充滿活力、充滿有生命力嘅博物館。呢個項目咧，是一个很大的挑战。第一，这个建筑物一定不可以像北京故宫。为什么呢？因为北京故宫是它几百年前当时当代一个文化的产品，也都是一个很独特性质的建筑物，天子的行政居住地方嚟噶嘛，唔係博物館嚟噶嘛。其實嗰陣時喺北京，可以話你有咗故宮，先至有個北京城，慢慢係圍住佢嚟做。成個北京城係以故宮做中心嚟到開展。嗱，香港呢度今時今日係一個展示北京故宮文化嘅博物館。所以它是一个以博物馆形式出现的建筑，所以是一个完全要适合香港都市文化形态的建筑物。但是你要人家看到个建筑物，你要跟故宫文化有联想才行，就是你不可以是一个看落哇像一个科技馆不啱，是不是？就算当代艺术馆都不啱。我哋就係用一個抽象嘅形式去表達，即係話成個建築物睇起上嚟係有一種中國古代或者傳統視覺藝術嗰種特質喺度，即係嗰種雍容嘅姿態啦，嗰種好巧妙嘅平衡啦，啊嗰種好收斂嘅華麗啦。好獨特的色彩和肌理，我們就是利用三個搭高的中庭是製造了那種這樣的空間聚合性，來到引人由下面走到上面。而這三個中庭你不會一眼看通的，你是慢慢一座一個這樣上去去發掘的。這個亦都是其實是北京故宮那種空間元素是用現代和適合香港都市形態的手法的可能性。
Hong Kong Palace Museum is only one of Rocco's astronomical masterpieces. He also designed the Guangdong Provincial Museum and the Yunnan Provincial Museum. In Hong Kong, from the university research buildings to the dormitories, from the airport express to the MTR stations, from the SAR government headquarters to the International Financial Center, he drew the city's outline by applying various architectural designs. Rocco's architectural style is rooted in his being born in Hong Kong and local upbringing, as well as local culture. He was admitted to the University of Hong Kong in 1970 to study architecture, paving the way for his future career.
大部分的同學，包括我自己，其實入去都是剛才講啦，都是一知半解嘅啫。對建築，即係同你話我讀醫生，你其實你都知道醫生嗰個要求或者係要做啲乜嘢。律師你都知道係乜嘢。讀建築，尤其是我畢業嗰個年代，即係中學畢業嗰個年代咧，其實唔係好多人知道係咩一回事。即係真係入到去就有少少話蒙查查去摸索。入咗去第一年，一開始做一個用竹搭嘅屋，就佢隨你想象啦，點樣用竹去做一個結構，一間茅屋俾人住。咁我第一次真係接觸到一個立體型嘅創作，慢就。
之后有冇攞好高分啊？
高分噶，高分噶，一个好大嘅鼓舞嚟噶，系啊。咁开始发觉，咦，可能我都有啲潜质喎，喺一方面，即系呢个系一个鼓舞嚟噶，系啊。建筑个人都话好多时候冇加分咁，啱嘅，好多时候冇加分。但系个好处系咧，你一交咗功课之后咧，你可以瞓三日啊，咁所以系。那個生活節奏好得意嘅，好得意。自細我係屬於乖仔嘅啦，即係好守規矩咁。我諗讀建築俾我其中一個好大嘅吸引力就係、是，你唔知邊個時候你會可以做到突破，唔知邊個時候你可以突然間有啲驚喜。
1983, Rocco won the first prize in the international competition at the Opera Bastille in Paris, France. Since then, he has won numerous domestic and international architectural design awards and has become one of the most influential architects in Hong Kong.
我而家讲紧八十年代啦，系难。八十年代当然系难啦。嗰、那個年代嘅信息係唔發達，冇互聯網，即係你就算係雜誌報章，你都係即係隔咗個時間，唔係即時。咁所以喺亞洲呢個區，包括香港，其實我哋對建築藝術嗰個認識，比起國外喺嗰個年代。是差好遠的，咁樣好似，因為嗰陣時好多移民嚟到啊，即係講五十年代、六十年代嗰陣時。跟住落去，你會見到好多玻璃大廈越嚟越高啦。嗰陣時係我哋經濟法起步，咁就要。迎合好多金融機構嚟到做總部啊，做生意啊，變咗金融中心開始。到咗回歸之後啦，可能開始啦。咁你會發覺我哋有好多時候咧，係講究人性化嘅環境多啲。多咗公共空間，就算喺我哋喺政府總部天馬樓。都有一個很大的公共空間融合在裏面被人用，不是只是講實際，不是只是講效率，亦都有很多舊建築，雖然剩下很少，亦都很刻意去保留，中環街市、大館，亦都見到很多城市的公共空間，包括現在的海邊，是開始盡量被人利用了。咁跟住又有比較講究嘅文化建築啦 ，M 家啦，戲曲中心啦，當然希望係包括故宮啦咁。咁所以開始反映社會對 生活質素，係精神生活質素嘅要求係高咗。咁所以你睇我哋嘅建築係睇到我哋嗰個社會嘅追求係開始有啲轉變。最近國內嘅建築同城市設計咧，其實都好講求人嘅尺度、人嘅感受，好人性化嘅空間。咁所以呢個係一個好好嘅方向啦。
Following China's reform and opening up, the country's economic development took off with a bang. The architectural industry flourished.Based on accelerating infrastructure development, China's modern architectural design has improved significantly, and a large number of national construction projects have been completed. The skyscrapers have sprung up, and the cities have taken on a new look. The development of modern architecture in China has entered a fast lane.
新的 department head.
Eric and Rocco got to know each other in 2009 at the Hong Kong Shenzhen Bi-City Biennale of Urbanism and Architecture. At the time, Eric was the curator and received support from Rocco, who was a member of the judging committee.
And I think the challenge that we were facingis that we want to have a biennale that really welcomed the world. And one challenging question we were always asked was, where the balance between what should become from the local voice and what should come from a global voice? It's not one or the other. And actually, you don't want to keep them apart. You want to have them interweave. And we want our influences out and influences from the outside in. And it's that dialogue that's really important.
呢、这個係好令人鼓舞嘅，啊，好令人鼓舞嘅。嗰、那個速度其實對我嚟講，我都覺得有少少驚奇，即係可以進步得咁快。亦都好難去估計，即係再過十年，國內嗰個水平去到邊度，可以快到去到邊度。咁但係我就有少少覺得，其實我哋又唔好要太過去介意我哋做出嚟嘅作品俾唔俾西方接受，因為建築始終係應該係服侍我哋本地嘅社會為主，即係針對本地嘅文化。
The prosperity of architecture is closely tied with the development and cultural communication of a country. Traditional Chinese culture is the cradle of diverse and mesmerizing architecture. In 2021, the central government promulgated the 14th Five-Year Plan, pledging support for Hong Kong to be an East meets West center for international cultural exchange.
咁呢個成個形態咧，有一種蓄勢待發咁樣一種咁樣嘅，其實有少少象徵我哋啱啱此刻呢個時代咧，係中國文化係一個重新起飛嘅歷史嘅時間。
In the future, every brick and tile in this city will tell the story of the Pearl of the Orient, as well as the story of the country.